Hi, we're students from the American School of Puebla, based in Mexico. The American School was founded in 1968 by Ms. Andrea Kings Butler. It has an amount of 2,406 students. The school is divided into three track campuses, that is elementary school, junior high, and high school.
Each campus has two ecology promoters that are in charge of making organizing campaigns and events that help the community and the environment. We have one recycling day a week in which students bring Tetra Pak, PET, cardboard, foil, and paper.
In the school, we have an ecology class as a complement to the biology class for first graders in junior high, and the two projects that we are presenting come from that class.
One of the main projects that the school has is about recycling and renaming the moda.
Wow. It's actually... By reusing waste materials for the manufacture of tubes, dresses, and accessories, making these allies innovation in eco-fashion.
This project was developed by a group of members of the Ecology Committee. Participating teams must find a name that identifies them as a team. Each team consists of five members, of which four are designers and one is the model that will use the dress and accessories.
Criteria to qualify. There is a jury that qualifies according to the criteria set. What the jury qualifies is that the material should be reused while taking into account the clothing and molding. And the criteria set is a group of
The model spoke on the runway, while his teammates described the materials used for the accessories and dresses. The accessories can be hats, bags, necklaces, wedding dresses, pants, and evening dresses.
The judges are experts in the field. Designers, people who are in charge of environmental groups, journalists, and teachers.
The best design and the best model are creditors of an award and also be able to participate in Eco Fashion, a project organized by the high school, by the American School of High School.
The Eco Fashion project brings the same characteristics of your model. The objective is to inform schools from the city of Puebla more about the environment and share as members of a community, a project that students will really enjoy.
Hello.
Saving stoves. This is another project from the environment class. We are Daniel Ruiz de la Concha and Rodrigo Rosas.
The community of Ayotzinapan is located in the town of Quetzalan. It is an indigenous area in which women aren't taken into account by their husbands. They are only allowed to do housework and sometimes their partner abuses from them. Also, there are diseases caused by carbon monoxide such as cancer and other respiratory illnesses. It is a really cold area, and the houses are made of cardboard or wood, so cold penetrates easily.
The food is made inside the house, so the women directly breathe the smoke. The American school takes action by implementing a project of installing stoves that use a little amount of firewood. So that allows women not to breathe healthier. It teaches women how to build the stoves and give them conferences to support their decision-making and economy. And Quetzalan is one of the biggest producers of coffee in Mexico.
In this picture, you can see the first stove that was made in the community for a family, but in this house, many, like at least three families. Objective, general objective, recover the affected areas by reduction in consumption of firewood. Specific objective, reforestation with different energetic species of quick growth so that it can be used as firewood for the stoves. global context, human ingenuity, and environment.
Benefits. Recovering the environmental factors such as forests, protection of the habitat, and reducing erosion. Increase the economic level of families of low resources. Decrease the time and money designated to obtain firewood and to reduce the risks of obtaining a respiratory illness. Promote the learning of the population, especially women, in the use and manage of sustainable natural resources.
Which are the challenges? The challenges that appear in the community is a little amount of trust towards the accomplishment from organization. Another factor is that women don't have the support from their husbands. Many people from the community do not know about the environment and the consequences that they can cause to it. The most challenging factor is the approval of the leader of the community called Juan Cepaz. In this picture, you can see the hallway of the community, and this is the bus in which we went to the community, and almost all the hallway is filled with firewood.
Advantages: safe and stable economy. It could be built by women or handcrafters of the community to reduce the use of firewood by 60%. It does not create smoke and concentrates high temperatures. This project creates environmental consciousness and promotes environmental responsibility in students, teachers, and representatives from the community.
After the investigation, the students took the initiative to implement the environmental impact studies and to give healthcare to the community through interviews. Also, the persistence of the project let us implement it in a really good way, and a group of students of the American School of Puebla took action and made it happen.
This is the project. The project achieved goals through campaigns and talks that the students exposed creatively.
This project was implemented by the students through investigation and analysis. This project contributed to the solution of an environmental problem. With this project, we decreased the amount of carbon dioxide emission and other gases. It is important to monitor the project and have a constant communication with the people of the town of Quetzalan to see if the project has an impact and if everything is working as planned.
We didn't know how to build, and we learned. This is the first stove that was built in a cooperative engagement. This action would prevent the irrational use of natural resources, in this case, the wood.
Students working together, sharing experiences in one project. Also, the community lacks vital resources like water, and these needs to be transported. So when we get to the community, we have helped them transport the things they need. In this picture, you can see how students are helping the people from the community.
Second stove. In this picture, you can see the leader of the community called Juez de Paz, who is a well-respected person and helps the community when they have problems. The second stove that was built was in the house of Juez de Paz. The stove still used firewood, but just a little. Women and children pick up branches that fall from the trees, and that's what they use as firewood.
The bricklayer who supported the project is an alcoholic and has a domestic violence issue. This project has allowed him to engage in other projects and also helped him to drink less. The project addresses an environmental problem. Although it is not in the community, it has a global impact, reducing the amount of gas.
Indigenous school. This is an elementary school in which kids go without having breakfast. Another project from the school is to implement a hen house and to build a stove next to it so that children can eat breakfast, especially eggs. The hens will eat typical seeds from the region, so they don't have to spend more money buying the food.
Benefits. If it is used correctly, the stove can decrease the emission of gases and the use of firewood by 25 to 50%. It reduces the risk of getting respiratory illnesses that are more common in women and children below the 5 years. Familiar integration, participation of women, and it also addresses an environmental problem. Little by little, more families are joining the project, so the new families that are in nearby communities will spread the word to other communities so this can be globally.
Results: a high level of participation from the students and environmental awareness. This project solves an environmental issue in the community, but with a global impact. The project creates environmental consciousness and responsibility in the members of the global community. These are the students that initiated the project.
And always that the students go to this town, they have breakfast, and the people from the community serve them breakfast from that region. And it's really nice to be with them. Experiences. After a hard and complete investigation of 6 years, over 15 firewood saving soaps were implemented in the community of Ayotzinapa, benefiting more than 20 families, spreading this project through all the community. Now, Rodrigo will demonstrate how we construct the firewood saving soaps in a scale model. And later we will explain. Obviously, the real one is way bigger, and you're gonna see the tube in which carbon monoxide starts to disintegrate and evacuate from the room, as we said, because it only uses small branches that fall from the tree. The trees, we don't have to put more trees, and also because it's a little amount of carbon dioxide, the tube can disintegrate it. And this part, it's the cooktop in which women from the community get allowed to cook, and the stove reaches really high temperatures, so the room keeps warm, so there's no problem with it, and women are safer now, and the death of women and children has reduced. So, and here's a tiny model of the stove. Now we will do some questions to see if you put attention, and if you get the answer right, you will receive a gummy.
A what?
Gummy.
What's the name of the leader of the community?
Something Paz. I don't know. It's Paz or something.
How much percentage of firewood decrease How much percentage of firewood decrease?
Was it 30?
It was between 25 and
30. How much money does the community spend on food for the
kids?
Wait, can you repeat that? How much money does the community spend on food for the kids? In what community was the project
implemented?
What are the problems that the big player have? What are the problems that the big player have?
We mentioned two issues that he had that
domestic violence and alcoholics.
From the other project, how many integrants does the group can have?
Four.
What does the jury call it?
Creativity, responsible, and deserving.
Okay.
Also, like right now we're gonna mention really fast, like other projects that the school have, like at least once a year, we go to many communities and give them aid, like food or
household items.
Yes. And also, as you saw in the video, the ecology class teaches first graders how to plant crops and also teaches them about many problems about ecology in the world. And that's basically it.
No, yeah, that's all.